Hi, I'm Natalie, and today I'm going to talk about Justin Bieber and P. Diddy, the whole thing there, but it's not really just about just. This is so much larger than that, and the message here is for all of us to change, because we can be part of a huge change here, I think. This whole thing comes with a big potential for change. I was editing the video and I realized people are gonna not understand why I'm talking about this, because I think it's very unexpected, and it really is for me too, but I'm just following my intuition. And that said, also, even if you're not interested in the whole Bieber situation, even if you know nothing about it, I still have this message to convey. It's come to light that P. Diddy was abusing children and stuff like that at his freak-off parties he has been known for, and so now there's a lot of footage pointing to that this has happened to Justin Bieber from when he was 15 years old. You can see videos where it's pretty clear that something was going on that we didn't know about, but it has been like hinted a lot. If you check that, you can kind of tell, and yeah, it's better if you look it up yourselves, but I've actually known about this since months ago. I found something about this on YouTube and I went down that rabbit hole, so I've watched a lot. I know a lot about the whole thing. So today I saw that there are people who are mocking Justin Bieber for this, which is awful. Like, they're laughing about it, like they think he deserved it or something, but it seems like to me that he went through something really awful. And if you look at, I will share a link in the description where you can get a big picture of what was going on when it comes to this Justin Bieber situation, when it comes to P. Diddy and all that, where you can see for yourselves and you can make up your own opinion. There's also a song that he made which makes it clear. It's very touching. I have never been a fan of Justin Bieber. I've never listened to his music, anything. I was one of the people who thought that, oh, Justin Bieber, you know, because everybody else did. And this is also what this video is about. Because I think that it's time for us to change this behavior where we just say things and think things because everybody else does. It's time for us to take responsibility for what we say and to think for ourselves, and not just do this or say that because it's okay because everybody else does it, or it's okay that this happens to this person because he's famous and he's a celebrity. This comes with the prize. That's just what you have to accept to be in that world, and he has everything, he can complain, because obviously that's not what makes you happy in life. Of course, having money and fame can be a good thing, but if that's the price to pay, I don't think that it's a good thing, and it shouldn't be accepted. And many people have accepted so much because they were maybe afraid to speak up, or they didn't understand the gravity of the situation because they've never experienced it themselves. Like, I think many people who are laughing about it now, they've never actually experienced anything like that themselves. So it's easy to like joke about it, but it's really disgusting. And that's also what my last video was about, where I was talking about, how there are things you can't understand, but you can become better at being compassionate about things that you can't understand by being aware that you don't understand everything, but that it can be really, really, really awful things that you're joking about because you don't have understanding. It's really sad, but it happens because, yeah, I think we're all kind of guilty of this behavior, but also at the same time you could say we're both responsible and victim of the herd mentality thing. Like, I think that this problem with young people, young children, and the celebrity stuff, and we've been accepting things, it became like a norm already, I think maybe during the rockstar era. Now that it's in the light, there's a big opportunity for us to change. But how do we change things? It starts with ourselves. You can't expect things to change if you don't change your own way of thinking. You have to take a look at yourself and realize that the change starts with you. And you might think that I can change anything, but yeah, but by thinking for yourself, if somebody says something and you evaluate that for yourself, do I really agree with this? Why do I agree with this? Why do I think that Justin Bieber sucks? Do I even know anything about him? For example, but this happens to many people, but we're taking celebrity because the thing is, if Justin Bieber can come out of this the other side and heal and become empowered in that, he can have a lot of power to change things too. Like, I believe that things happen for a reason, and so maybe he had to go through this thing to come out stronger the other side and be empowered, and he will have the potential to make big change. Because the light that's being shed is just such a big spotlight thing. I'm sorry if I'm not expressing this well. I think it's easy for somebody who never experienced any similar situation to this themselves to not take it very seriously and to, like it's easier to just make fun of it. It's hard to... It's hard to understand because the psychology around this is so complicated. And I have not been in, obviously I've not been in Justin Bieber's situation, but I have enough experience in my life to understand the psychology around this without going into details. There's so much shame associated to this and confusion because he's been groomed. And so he was young and confused and he's been groomed and he probably started doing things like there's a mentality here like where you, because you can't do anything about it or it seems like if I accept this and if I participate willingly in this, it will not be as bad because then it's my choice. And so it feels like you're taking back part of your power by yourself. This is so complicated. So I saw then a post about Justin Bieber's wife, Hailey Bieber. His wife had said, please stop, because now Justin Bieber has shut off, which I really relate to. If you watch my Burnout video, I talked about that. I talked about how I shut off, and I realized now that maybe I needed to do that because it was very overwhelming. And he probably did also shut off in the past, where just to be able to deal with all these things, he's been detached. That's why it's so confusing for people, because maybe it looked like he wanted to be there, or I don't even think maybe it looked that way, maybe sometimes, because that's the, you detach to be able to deal with the situation, you shut off part of yourself, and that's sad that he has to do that again. But I completely understand why he would shut off, because wow, having the world look at this, it is the situation, which is very, very vulnerable. He must feel so small and lonely, and oh, I can't imagine being in his shoes right now. But just to say that I can relate to that, I understand the psychology around this and the shame and the confusion, the fear of people outside of this situation judging you and not and blaming you and mocking you and making fun of you. Oh my God, I feel like it's our job to support him, and in supporting him, supporting everybody else who also have been abused, sexually abused, children or anyone. Children or anyone. Is it not funny? It's not funny, it's not a joke. Still I see people, crying, yeah, he's a victim. And he always has been, I think, because this started when he was 15. And his parents sent him away, sent him into the situation. I don't know if they trusted PDD, probably, I guess, maybe they felt lucky. They felt like he was lucky. But it must have been so confusing for him. There's a lot of footage of people, all other people treating him weird, and he was actually saying something and standing up for himself, but nobody reacted. It's crazy. It's crazy, even though probably we didn't see it, but now it's time for us to see, because now it's time for us to change. This is child abuse and sexual abuse, and it's not something to joke about. It doesn't matter if it's Justin Bieber. It doesn't matter if it was okay to mock Justin Bieber for so long. If you're ignoring this, and if you're laughing about it, if you're making fun of it, you're being part of the problem. So if you want to be part of the change, you have to change your own way of thinking. And then your way of thinking can influence other people, and there can be a snowball effect on this. So this is what this video is about. And this is about changing like everything. We see this in comments on like Instagram or whatever, that people mock people and they see other people doing it as well. They see other people doing something and then they think it's okay because they do it. So. It's not okay to do something just because other people do it. Start recognizing that. And before making a comment, think about it. Think about it. Am I doing this? Would I say this? Is this okay? Is this really okay? This is a person. It's not okay. You can think things for yourself. You don't have to go participate in the bullying. It's just we have to change, and it starts with you. And you can instead of when you realize, oh shit, I should not be thinking this way because I'm just being influenced by these other people. This is not really my own thoughts. I can't stress enough how awful I think it is. So people are laughing at this and mocking, because it's adding to an already difficult situation. And this happens to a lot of women who are sexually abused as well. They're really the shame and the disgust and the fear of not being believed. And they start maybe wondering if they have some responsibility in it, because everybody is because there are people who don't believe them. There are people who put the blame on you. There are people who say you deserve it. There are people saying it's their own fault. They accepted it, or they invited it. I would guess that grooming is, never been groomed, but I've been manipulated. I think it's kind of the same thing. I mean, there is a lot of manipulation, if I understand correctly. In grooming is manipulation, and manipulation really fucks with your mind. I think that when it comes to these situations, the mental abuse is worse, is the worst. The mental abuse. This physical abuse is bad, but the mental abuse is what fucks with your mind. It really fucks with you. It makes you question yourself. Did I? Yeah, it's so confusing to be manipulated, and it's because you do things you don't want to do because you're manipulated into doing it. But then you feel shame because you did it. You did something, but it's so complicated. It's really, that's the mental abuse. It's awful. Like, okay, let's take an example. I don't know. I mean, I don't know if you've seen Outlander because I don't know who's watching, but in Outlander, spoiler alert if you haven't seen it and if you don't want to know, but in Outlander there's a scene. There are two men, and so this one man is takes Jamie in to his personal little jail because he's a fucking crazy psychopath, and so he abuses him sexually for a long time. But the thing that I want to come to, the scene that really fucked with my mind, because I'm so disgusted just watching it. It's not even real, but I know this happens, and I can understand. Like I've said before, I'm an empath, and I can feel it very. It becomes so real. It's hard to talk about even. The mental abuse there is that he talks to Jamie about his wife, who he loves, and he makes him think about his wife while he is raping him. And so he kind of manipulates the situation into, how can I explain this? He gets him to have a pleasure, feel pleasure, feel bodily pleasure. He's manipulated into this, finding pleasure while being abused. Like, that is the kind of mental abuse. That this is not that, but if you can empathize with that scene in Outlander, then you can understand kind of what this is about. This mental fuck, how this fucks with your mind. Because you feel guilty when you're violated. It doesn't have to be that you feel pleasure, but that it really makes it obvious how something can fuck with your mind. Because I think that anybody watching that scene could understand how awful that, horrible that is. So having people thinking that you wanted something, that's where I want to come with this point. When other people think that you wanted something that was actually abuse to you, that's even more abuse. That's abusing you. That's abusing you all over again. That people say that you wanted something when you were abused, that's abuse. Fuck, so disgusting. The thought of people thinking you wanted something that you didn't when you were in this vulnerable situation is disgusting. The thought of having to defend yourself, the thought of having to explain, ugh. I can't imagine just being in that situation in public. That's why so many people don't speak up. And just, you've watched that song he sang live, the Lonely song, because it's heartbreaking. And people saw this and they didn't say anything, they didn't care about him. I really empathize with that.